senior. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, 2017 NL Honors graduate. Thank you, thank you. I would accident at the time. Just a couple of opening remarks. First of all, we're very, very proud of you. This is a kind of a big deal for the city of Dayton. Having engaged citizens is really, really important to us. And I just want to say thank you. There's a lot of time and effort involved. And again, thank every one of you. Before I get started, though, I do want to acknowledge Verletta Jackson. So let's give Verletta a hand. You guys know how hard she works. She puts in a lot of time, a lot of hours, and she's very dedicated, and she's very a prized possession for the city of Dayton, so we want to thank her. Again, I don't think I've introduced myself. My name is Brian Ingreen. I'm the acting director, actually, for the Department of Planning and Community Development, and again, we want to thank you very much. We've got a couple speakers lined up. I want to first introduce the mayor, and Ann Whaley wants to give a couple of opening remarks.
Well, good evening, everyone. Congratulations. I have to tell you, I've been to probably 10 graduations, and I don't think we've ever had such an exciting entrance, right, Verletta? No, so definitely, and everyone's here and very excited. I don't know if you're excited that you went through the NLI process or you're excited that you're finished. So I want to just thank you. Thank you for your time, your willingness to spend your time to learn about your city and how you can impact change in our city. As Brian said, committed citizens are what's going to make a difference in our community. And the work that you have done these past 10 weeks, getting to know both the great things that are happening in our city and then the challenges and opportunities we have as well, and how we can make a difference collectively, will make a difference for our community. This past week, Commissioner Dean Lovelace passed away, and you know, Dean, I served with Dean for 10 years on the Dayton City Commission, and I think you know he came. Through the grassroots neighborhood action work, ran for city commission, I think, 3 times before he was elected, and never gave up on his community. And you know, really had a strong belief and a strong understanding that citizens could make a difference and could make a difference in their community. And he believed that in his core, and fought for that every single day when he was on the commission and even before when he was organizing. And so, when I think of neighborhood leadership, and I think of the work that you all are doing, and of course think of Commissioner Lovelace, especially this week, because you embody the way that you believe about the city of Dayton. And so I want to say thank you for living that legacy as well. I also want to thank Sinclair College, Madeline Thier. They've just been terrific partners for us in this effort. Give them a round of applause. Again, I've been going to these for a decade, and we've never been in this enormous room for this event, Madeline, so that's new for us. I'll find new things this year, which is really great. And also want to thank RTA for their sponsorship as well. Always a great partner with us, and they probably did the trip in the RTA bus yesterday, so that's very good. That's way better than the van we used to have, so you've really stepped up. So I just want to say thank you. On behalf of the City Commission, I know Commissioner Williams was here earlier, Commissioner Mims will probably say a few words in a moment, Commissioner Sean, Commissioner Joseph, you all are what makes the city stronger and better, and engagement, and now you are leaders to share that with others, to make sure that people participate, and quite frankly, now more than ever, we need the participation of the Dayton. I'm sure you've been told and hear, you know, the cuts that the new administration in Washington, D.C. Threatens to our communities, not only to the city of Dayton, like community development block grants and home that keep people sheltered, but also, you know, works in America. food pot, food bank, works across the city, things that don't even come to the city of Dayton, but really affect our citizens. And now more than ever, we need your voice, we need your talent, and we need your action to make sure that we can continue to move our city forward. So I'm counting on that from you, and counting on you to tell your friends, and to use your voice as aggressively as possible to make our city better and protect those that don't have any access in our community. So I hope you'll do that, and I just want to say thank you and congratulations. Have a great one.